it is raining fucking hard urine outside.
It's raining cats and dogs out there. Bork, bork, Sparky, no! Oh, God, why?
Why did it have to be this way? Why have you forsaken my puppies, Lord?
Oh, man, I gotta poop, dude.
Oh, no.
After this episode ends, I'm gonna take a wicked dump.
Thanks.
I hope you're ready for it.
If it's yellow, let it mellow. If it's brown, flush it down.
Skip the cutscene.
Skip.
What is this place? A barn?
Yeah, it looks like there have been some freak reports of, blackouts and shit, so you should probably watch out for that, Anyway, I'm done on, I finished the radio now, I'm done. Goodbye.
Mary, grab me 17.
Property of Ross Oldhamavan.
Ross Oldhamavan's diary.
Dear Diary, Aaron is out of control. He's melted two toilets in the past week. If he gets the last one, we'll all have to use the vase again. This can't go on. I discovered earlier today that the spell book I brought online actually works on Halloween. I've cast a magic spell on the bathroom door that will stop Aaron from getting in. He'll need 12 good boy coins, and he'll never find them in time. He'll make bears in his pants, but it's for the greater good. Also, it says in the book that there is a 1 in 1 million chance of Aaron being sent to a distorted hell dimension, but that'll never happen. It's so unlikely. Anyway, I'm going to go sleep in my car because the developer ran out of time to model me. Goodbye, future me, who is the only person who will ever read this.
Vile lexicon, book of Grimcraft and naughty spells, warning spells will actually work on Halloween.
Chapter 1 Toilet Stuff. Hello to all the sexy witches and wizards out there. Here is the first spell. If your boss keeps melting the toilets in your work office, then this is the spell for you. It's a more common problem than you'd think. More than one person in the US eats fast food. Repeat these words in front of the bathroom door. Wham, bam, buzzle, kazam. Put the pink in the stink. Take me to the promised land. Once the spell is complete, the effects will be as follows. Your boss will be locked out of their bathroom until they acquire 12 good boy coins, and there is a 1 in 1.000000 chance of your boss being sent to a distorted hell dimension. If by chance your boss has already melted all available toilets, below is the spell to turn a vase into a fully functional toilet. You'll still need to hire a plumber to install it and all that shit, but it's great at giving the illusion of having a toilet. Toilets can also be repurposed as shelving fuel to burn or something to eat dinner off of. Anyway, the magical words are vase become a toilet wee fiddle dee dee. Aaron's fanfiction. Okay, here goes. This is my hot and spicy Dan/fanfiction. Dan sat in the grump room patiently awaiting Aaron's return. He had left several hours ago to make dookie, but Dan was beginning to worry. Aaron should have finished pooping like 10 minutes ago. Where is he? Dan began to feel nervous when suddenly he felt a hand gently grab him on the shoulder. Aaron, Dan said excitedly, but looking up, he noticed that this mysterious figure wasn't Aaron at all. Who are you? The mysterious figure leaned closer to Dan, revealing his face. Could it be? Dan gasped in shock. The mysterious figure was none other than Dan. Dan stared sensually into Dan's eyes as they both leaned in for the kiss. Oh, Dan, please take me, Dan whispered into Dan's ear. Of course, Dan, my love, replied Dan, also in a whispering voice. Dan embraced Dan's warm embrace. Dan's body was soft and warm against Dan's body. Dan asked Dan, will you be gentle? It's my first time, Dan asked. Bro, I'm going to drill your hole open so hard it will never shut again. My dick will rotate clockwise at a rate of 1000 RPM, generating soothing friction within your internals. Shit, dude, that's so hot, replied Dan. Aaron returned to find Dan and Dan cuddling on the couch. Ah, Dan, I see you've met Dan. He's the newest member of our team. Oh, we've met, Dan said with a cheeky grin. Little did Aaron know that Dan was now male pregnant with Dan's baby. But who is the real father? Is it Dan or is it Dan? Now it's only a matter of time before his water breaks and the beans are still the end. Dear Aaron, dearest Aaron, I simply refuse to let you melt the last functioning toilet in the office with your atomic diarrhea. Please, I don't want to have to use the vase again. The only way to open this door is to collect 12 good boy coins, but you'll never do it in time. Sorry, Aaron, it's the only way. Please don't fire me for this, Ross.
Oh, I can't hold it no much longer. Thank you.
fun, fun for everyone. Fun, fun, fun for everyone.
Shit.
There's no fucking light.
Well,
fucking, it's so dark.
You got the flashlight?
I sure do.
Okay.
using they are much more dangerous. You must remain hidden from them, because if they see you, you won't last long. An extra life will spawn somewhere in the office every several layers or so. These extra lives can help you travel deeper and deeper. The deeper you go, the more inhabitants you will encounter, and the more dangerous they will become. According to legend, this dimension has no beginning or end and will go on forever. It's a shame you can't just, like, jump out the window or something, but the programmer couldn't be bothered to add that penis pineapple belongs on pizza. Don't add me, fuck it, I'll go a step further. They need to start selling pineapple stuffed crusts. Fuck it, make pineapple stuffed crusts the default option, and you have to opt out. Also, banana is quite good on pizza as well. Anyway, good luck.
Supposed to be there. You've fallen out of reality or some shit. It's like ultimate dimension. Everything's all spooky. Including me, boo. Yeah. Anyway, good luck.
An English teacher's analysis.
G.T is a far deeper and more meaningful game than most in the academic world give it credit for. Most will only view things on a surface level, but upon further inspection, the surface is only the tip of the iceberg. For instance, when Aaron is sent to the alternate hell dimension, it's actually symbolic for his fear of judgment after melting yet another toilet. Aaron has relapsed into past mistakes and must face the music.
Likewise, the rain is symbolic for how everyone will have to shit in the face for a while until new toilets are fitted. The part of the game where Aaron shits a lot is symbolic of the developer's crippling addiction to being awesome at making video game shit busts. Dan is symbolic of Aaron, and likewise Aaron is symbolic of Dan, as their friendship has turned them into reflections of each other, much like the alternate universe is a reflection of the regular universe, but with a more spooky vibe going on. The question is raised then, who is the spookier grump? Dan or Aaron? In conclusion, you should always overanalyze everything, because usually the color of the curtains is thematic or some shit.
Happy Aaron, happy life.
We'll shine the flashlight in his face. Maybe he'll go away.
I'm gonna crouch. It makes me quieter.
I didn't like that. Uh-oh. God damn it, Aaron.
Sorry.
Yeah, dude, I farted on him.
Good. Good job, Aaron.
Happy air and happy life.
God damn it, Aaron.
Sorry. Yeah, dude, I farted on him.
Good job. Good job, Aaron. Skip. Skip the cutscene. Skip the cutscene.
Skip. What is this place, a barn?
Yeah, it looks like there have been some freak reports of, like, blackouts and shit.
Oh, I can't hold it no much longer.
Shit. Fun for everyone. Fun for everyone.
Ah, shit.
Shit.
There's no fucking light.
Well,
fucking, it's so dark.
You got the flashlight?
I sure do.
Okay.
Happy air and happy life.
We'll shine the flashlight in his face. He'll go away.
Alright, I'm gonna crouch. It makes me quieter.
Ha ha ha.
Yeah, dude, I farted on him.
Didn't like that.
Ha ha ha.
Well, we sure had fun. God damn it, Aaron.
Sorry.
Happy life. You know what? Fuck this game. I fucking hate it. We're done. Okay, well, I guess we just learned an important lesson, didn't we?
Ha ha ha!
that bad? Is that good?